You know, it's so exciting and so reassuring to be here as a representative of the patients, or of the patient's voice, if you like, because for many, many years we've been listening to patient involvement and patient inclusion as, you know, a buzzword, which is something that needs to be done in biomedical development and in regulatory processes and da-di-da-di-da. But nobody has ever really taken it seriously. So oftentimes it's just a tick box exercise. While in this project, we've been involved from the very beginning. And this particular event is a very good proof for showing how seriously patient involvement is taken within the Harmony project. Namely, the patient communities have been involved in setting the key outcomes and defining the main objectives, and also the working processes of the project, which I think is tremendously empowering. It's not just useful from a research and development perspective, which it obviously is, and I can explain why, but it's also a tremendously empowering thing for patients to see that people who have similar conditions or who live with similar malignancies have an active say in what's going on in such a massive and important project. And also, I mean, honestly, if you consider the simple fact that in order to let this whole big data process happen, someone has to produce these data. And it's us patients who manufacture these data, literally. So there's also a huge ethical debate and a very exciting discussion going around or happening around these aspects. And that's why it's also tremendously important to be here and to be able to speak on behalf of patients. Because we hope a lot of things to come out of this project. We hope better treatment, we hope better access to treatment, we hope better access to data, we hope to see more relevant outcomes. We hope to see fruitful and successful debates with clinicians and regulators about what matters for the patients and how that can be coordinated with what matters for other stakeholders. And in case of other stakeholders, it's particularly important to focus on regulators, because honestly, if you think about the EMA, the European Medicines Agency, they have done some exemplary work in including patients in their decision-making processes and in their working parties and in their commissions. So there's a rule that patients must be involved, and this rule is being taken very seriously. But if you go to the national level, it can be very different. And oftentimes, once again, patient representation, patient involvement remains very tokenistic. And that's what we try to change by demonstrating that patients can make a meaningful impact. We're not just figureheads, but we are people who are oftentimes highly educated about their illnesses and can make a meaningful impact. So, you know, it's science, it's only knowledge. And if you could learn it, I can learn it too. So it's not magic. And that's why it's tremendously important to showcase that patients are there and they have a voice and they use this voice actively.